a shot in anger. Can they get something going here? Go to the back, and Thomas, good hands to hang on to that one. No problem this time with the French handling, as they're going to go wide here, looping past to Guérin. I spoke too soon. We went backwards, though. Grassino picks it off the deck. Lina Guérin. Chloe Pell to Thomas. Two outsider. Flat pass, but again, it's another knock-on. It's another unforced error. Advantage for Russia. They're going to try and capitalise here. Bobkova. Pass on the outside. Hamidova. Hamidova goes through the tackle. Hand off, and then she's going to reach. Podestiek. Nice flat line, but equally good tackle came in from Chloe Pell. Hamidova, one outsider. Can she get the hand away? That looked like a decent hit to stop her on the 5 metre line. Drakova, desperate French defending. Russia testing those tackles with every pass. An advantage being played to Russia. Hamidova losing her strength at the line.
French ball.
There's the tap. Chance for Russia. Almost at the line.
Now off this, off this platform.
Ball off the top. Again from France to use. Good take that time from Goulian. Straight onto the pitch. Now we might see Grassino in a bit of space here. She is. Little stop and a handoff. She goes. A pocket rocket. Drakova makes the hit. What an offload that was. Absolutely top class. Here, and look at the commitment there and the contact from Goulian, I think it was, who went up for that ball. And whatsoever for her own personal safety. Hamidova wasting no time getting on with it. And Russia looking to add another try. Look at the offload. Drakova now. Any room for her on the outside? Little check and stop. But back in. Decent tackle though from Clémence Goussier. As Russia keep it alive. Spun out wide. Courson trying to find Hamidova. Hamidova gets the hand and the pass away on the inside. Beautiful. Difficult pull this one. New Zealand obviously and Japan, the hosts, will be hoping for a good showing and fresh from qualifying for the series next year. Kicking clear. Mikhaltsova is going to get her second. Expertise to compete with Russia. Here's Mikhaltsova. Waste no time in getting on with it. Russian number four. Looping pass on the outside. And here's Drakova. We see me once. And off she goes. Mikhaltsova to restart. Switches tack and a little grubber kick through to try and catch Japan unawares. The pass on the outside is beautifully timed. And the space opens up. The home fans shouting for the try. Almost there. Taniguchi just held the 4 to 5 metre line. Did that go forward? It went backwards as the referee. Mbogin Adraminadave dropped it. And chance for Mikhaltsova to try and spread this. Overlap on the right hand side if Russia can get it out there. Bobkova swallowed up in the middle. Hamidova. Japan having to defend now, but comfortably inside their own 22. Well, it looks like it's going to be another one. Foot race on. Sprinting away is Skoromko. Is she going to be caught? She is. Brilliant chase by Nakamura. And then the pass. Well, if they stop. Mikhaltsova again going for the grubber kick. There's not enough on that one, so Japan will have advantage. And it's Nakamura. Tries to go through. Kuai keeps the ball alive. Mbogi and Jaminadave over the halfway line. A lovely pass out the back, but unfortunately Mayo Shimizu couldn't hold on to it, and Russia Mikhaltsova will try and attack. Here's Bobkova. That one went forward. Mikhaltsova with the feed and the pass. Well, nice diving action. Pity there was nobody where the pass went. Russia still with the ball though, and Japan forcing them back inside the 22. Decent tackle by Yuki Ito. Again, blitz defence. Mikhaltsova, no option but to take that in. But Japan forgot to put the tackle in. They forgot to put her on the ground. And if you do that and give her any kind of space, she will punish you. I'm sure Mikhaltsova can't quite believe that. She was waiting for the hit that never came. Feed from Mikhaltsova. Looping pass over the heads. Podestiak is there. Two outsider. Russia looking pretty ominous. Pretty ominous again. Drakova turns on the afterburners. Drakova. I have a funny feeling. Had Baranovski been in the middle there, he'd be giving out to his players that they weren't even more ahead. But Japan, can they strike a blow here? Because they do have those little line breakers in their team, as we know. Transfer to Tsumi to try and get in behind the defence. Illegally, quick tap and off they go. This is Shimizu. Shimizu trying to go around the outside. Good tackle from Dukova. The pass is beautiful! Dukova is going to take her place in the wing. Hamidova, ball off the top to use. Nice pass from Perestiek. Here she is, the substitute. First touch for her. Loretina! Now you see that. Now you don't. Off she goes. What a try for...
It is underway. New Zealand with first possession through their captain, Goss, who just taps it back to where Nathan Wong. Brazier out to Williams. Williams over the head of Blythe. So Williams now used to cart the ball forward. The offloads are working well. Michaela Blythe driven out towards the sideline. Does a good job in staying strong and places the ball there inside their own 22. Nathan Wong at first receiver. Tui takes a bit of the yardage and then gives it to her captain. Now it's out to Woodman. Woodman, powerful. Top try scorer in the competition is Woodman for the World Series in New Zealand. Now moving it one way and then the other. Nathan Wong to Brazier. Lovely sevens ball movement on that occasion again. Williams couldn't find her winger in Blythe. Now Williams goes down that touchline, sweeping a beat, step on the inside. The pace comes on, and New Zealand's match. Nathan Wong, Brazier sets it. The decoy runners, Goss, two on one. Nathan Wong to the line. Blythe looking to open her account here in Japan. Gets the ball back, and now the width being shown here from New Zealand. They'll look to get it to Woodman. The kick from Tui. Woodman lets it bounce. Woodman 1-1. Hamidova again goes high. This time just batters it back with one hand, and Brazier goes through to get it to give it to her captain, Tui. If anyone deserves a try, it's Ruby Tui. It's Kaya. And jersey 11 replaces Hamidova. They run wide, lateral, and then they give a lovely ball out to Drakova. Has the sweeper on Drakova! Magnificent! That is what
going into the tackle and recycling.
Spirited defense from Russia, New Zealand will just kick it out here. I don't think they'll be too worried about more points, but Brazier kicks it for Woodman. Here comes the flyer. Woodman using her strength now, rips the ball clear. Brazier, who put the kick forward, gets it out. Robbins ready. Another kick, the bump and run. Robbins ready. No, she didn't knock it on, and so Sarah Goss holds on to the ball. New Zealand looking for another try. Cordero Tufunga goes eight short. Goss to the left they go. Robbins ready. Tui, it's gone backwards, still keeping it alive. Brazier is there. Fata Simpkins will get the next pass, and then they've got Woodman out wide. Fata Simpkins will set up Woodman, the top try scorer. Perfect conditions here in Kitakyushu as we get underway. Canada through Stacey bobbles the ball, but it goes backwards. Now out to Ben. Brittany Ben quickly gets over the advantage line and over the 22. Julia Greenshield. Stacey again. Farella to Kish. Into the contact, back to Farella. They're making their tackles, first up tackles from the Russians. Landry to Ben. Ben spots a gap, gives it back. Short ball to her captain. Try number one for Canada. And Ghislaine Landry opens their accounts.
The park for her.
Kish will get up and compete, but the Russians finally get a chance to get their hands on the ball and look for their structure. Look to try and move the ball into the midfield. Into the clash they go. Hamidova is there. And now out to Mikhaltsova. Distinctive colored dreadlocks for the Russian flyer. Hamidova goes in and has to clear it out. The line speed from Canada is so good that they're going to have to run across the field, and then look at Canada just holding their line, holding their defence.
Use it.
It's resolute defence from the Canadians. Now Canada, the Russians. Mikhailtsova again gets it, an offload. This is Petrova. Nice pass. Finds some space, and there's plenty of it down that right-hand side. Russians just playing in the middle of the field. Now they've found some space, and they break out. Sweep and a beat. Landry does well. Just to hold her up and buy some time. Ben has done brilliantly to steal it. Good chance here for Canada on the counter-attack. Farella tried to get it at the hands of Darling. Hannah Darling gets it eventually. Breaks through the first. Jen Kish back to Green Shields. Green Shields breaks away.
Graham, so she's a big center out there.
They win the ball. Stacey comes around. The captain Landry thought about offloading to Ben, who came back on the cut. Stacey looped around. Now out to Green Shields. Wonderful fend. Yesterday, 31 in her career, but she has got pace. And they give it to her immediately as well to go to work on Green Shields. They loop around. Did Ben lose that forward? No, says the referee. Kish is in.
She's an excellent player.
Canada from inside their own 22. The kick and chase for Williams. Charity Williams. How's the bounce? Not quite perfect for her, but she secures possession. Landry will finish it. Unbelievable. Well, put it down to the class of their defensive work to get.
Standing right up by that scrum. She's going to be putting pressure on at the back there. Snuff the ball out.
Yeah, that's just changing tactics too, isn't it? They come back on the cut, but the tackles have been made. It's a good one from Farella. And that forces another error from the Russians, and it means more possession for the Canadians. Watch him, Roy. Out now to Nicholas. Gets it out to Williams. Charity Williams! And at the corner!
Oh.
We're looking for 40. They'll be wanting to post as many points as they can. Williams finally gets it, slips over. Buys a bit of time that the defence can get there. Farella, she's a prolific try scorer. Gets the offload. Canada showing how to play this great game of sevens by using space. Russia look interested, and they've got the turnover. Looking to get off the donut, Russia. They've got numbers out here to the left. Now it's just a matter of running straight, drawing and passing. Some nice sidestep. Some good work coming in there from Bob Culver. Gets the ball out the back. Russia, best real opportunity. Noritina gets it back, and this is Lidovskaya. Mikhailtsova, big tackle coming in on her. Good lineup here for Russia. They've got numbers. Now they look to go straight. Inside pass would work here. The cut. Then they go in and out. Thought about passing, but better option was to hold on to it because it would have been a forward pass. Charity Williams goes in and steals the ball. Farella gets it wide. They've only got six defenders, Russia. And now they get it out wide to Nicholas. Pass on the inside. Watch him, Royal score.
She's really good break. And just a pity they couldn't finish it off. Kukina taps for Russia. Switch in the middle. And backwards comes Petrova, the captain. And that ball meant to go wide. Didn't find the target. And Russia just happy to suck in a couple of French defenders who are making life difficult, as they always do in defence, France. Spotting a gap down there. Lina Grant gives chase. It's going to be a foot race for the line. Who's going to get to Giran? It's more than enough pace to make the tackle. And the technique was beautiful. Now has to release, and up she goes. Hamidovin supports. Chloe Pell makes the hit, but Cobra runs into the granite block. That is Camille Grassino. Overlap on the left-hand side. Surely if they spin this one, Mikhailtsova calling for it. Drakova on the outside, unmarked. Oh, Mikhailtsova, was it the right decision? Yes, it was! Russia restart. Nice take underneath the high ball there from Grassino. Again, look at Russia contesting at the breakdown and getting their hands on the ball. That's brilliant work in defence. Hamidova, options on the left-hand side, takes the pass to Kukina. Hamidova again looking to break and get the hands free. Well, that was an important double team on the big Russian because she was trying to get the pass to Mikhalsev, who was screaming for it on the outside. Russia going to attack on the right-hand side now. Cross the pitch. They go. Drakova trying to find the gap and the handoff on Kiran and Drakova for Russia. The gap just four between the pair. Drakova doesn't look like she's ready to quit anytime soon. Long looping pass there from Gussier. Switches tack to this side and again, not the best of passes and Russia seemed to read it. Look at Hamidova lifting at the breakdown, creating possession and then the line up the middle, and the offload as well is good. Russians giving chase here, and looks like they're going to cross for a third try. Gussier is going to feed, and Russia win it against the head. And off they go again. Perestiak just delayed the pass. Big thumping tackle that was from Caroline Drouin. Russia get it back. Hamidova wrapped up. That's better from France. That's more like the aggression that we come to expect from them in defence. But they still can't get their hands on the ball. Perestiak goes wide, and there, waiting for it is Drakova. It's going to be a difficult first task for Akemba to try and stop her, but she does that really well. And Akemba, look at the strength to rip the ball free, and then she throws it forward. After doing the hard work, she gave it away. Mikhalsova, a little grubber kick through. France has to be careful not to give away a penalty. Mikhalsova looking for a second here. Is it going to go too far?
I'm really interested to see her more.
Yeah, physically, she is very impressive. As you saw there when she ripped that ball. France trying to keep it alive at the moment. Doing a pretty good job over two, stretching the legs over the halfway line. Gussier, can she get there? She's going to be tracked down surely. No, still going. Hamidova just about gets back to make the tackle. Still there. Surely for France. Oh, did it? For Perestiak to throw. Hamidova the target. She gets up, takes it one-handed. And ball off the top. Mikhalsova just drifting across slightly, then a switch with France. More than enough players to deal with it. And Skoromko ran into traffic. Here's Hamidova. A lovely handoff and another. Two in a row and then runs into traffic. Gets it away though. Good pass. Just keeping her composure. Kukina spreads it wide. Out to Drakova. This is an interesting matchup. These two. How quick is she? Oh, that's how quick. And she makes it look so easy.
Wow.
Quick tap. Okemba swings a long one out to this near side. Jade Lepesque.
Russia with the position and they go to the line and then try and find some space for their top try scorer. Watmore gets fended off by Kazakova, one of the more experienced players in this Russian team. And then they go into the contact inside the 22. Kazakova plays halfback. They run across the field and throw a big wide pass out to Mikhalsova. Not how it can get up and go again. Hamidova is there, Fisher with the ankle tap. Mikhalsova thought that she was in. It's not over yet for the English. The cut there forces the error again. Alice Richardson says, let's get on with the game. Good lineup of English players out to the right. That is McLean out to her captain, Brown. Fisher goes on the attack now. Good contest there between Fisher and Pedrova. They've gone 50 metres, have the English. Now they get into enemy territory and one more pass to Watmore. If that had gone to hand, it was really interesting. Joe Watmore showing good strength. Scott goes in. Wood out to Richardson. McLean takes it to the line. Players either left and right, goes into the tackle. Hamidova's there. Fisher again, but this time they've lost it and Pedrova has the ball. Now Russia with a real opportunity. Well, it's wall-to-wall action and who's the quickest on the park at the moment, that's going to be the difference. Richardson copybook tackle. Russia have got a nice lineup out to the left. And they've knocked it, Fisher, and now they tap and go. Kazakova. Who's going to break? Where is the gap? Where's the fatigue? And who's going to score first in this game?
Was it a knock on there?
Hamidova puts the big mid out. Tries to get around Fleming. Can't do it. Gets the offload though. Into Drakova. Drakova! In to score the first. And referee's time. And finally, Mel, someone scored. Oh. An error from the English. Drakova again on Fleming. This is a good contest between these two sprinters, two speedsters. Fleming's got to get out of there, and she does. Kazakova, one of the more experienced Russian players, now married. And so I should call her Koromko. But here come Russia again down that right-hand flank. The offload is working well for them. One-on-one, in, out and around. Scott comes, makes the tackle on Petrova. The offload and the... Fought back well to win the match against France. And leading by 14 points to nil in this game. As the Culver again tries to get on the outside of Fleming. That tackle was high. The tap and go. Mikheltsova. So strong is Mikheltsova. The offload is working well for Russia in this game. Mikheltsova again goes down Main Street and scores. Our game, don't they? Not afraid of getting into the contact battles against the bigger sides as Mikheltsova goes on one of those trademarks runs out to the sprinter and finisher. Last passage of play. England through Watmore. Works the ball back inside their own 22. Scott with a lovely crisp pass out along the chain. They have lost it again, unfortunately, for England. And Russia will be looking forward to trying to make it 30. They'll play the advantage. Mikheltsova gets it out. Russia on the attack again. Russia finished with another.